Hi, this is for 3D Art 2. This is going to be a video that's going to discuss our next project for the next 2 weeks. So we are focusing again on the subject of found objects. However, we are going to be creating a famous painting. So what this video is going to show you is just the PowerPoint that is downloaded in eCampus. It's under Files and it's called Famous Paintings 3D Art 1 for 4/13. April 13th through April 24th. That's how long this project will be for the next 2 weeks. So, as I discuss this project, I just want to go over a few things with you. Same as if I was in class with y'all. So, if this video could help you in any way, or if you still have other questions, please feel free to just email me on my school email and I will get back to you. So the name of this project is called The Famous Well-Known Painting, and you're going to be using found objects again. So for this project, I'm just going to run through what you're going to do for your project notes for this week is you're going to be researching a famous painting from art history and understand the content, which just simply means what the scene, what is going on in that particular painting, and the context. So history of the time period, what's going on, is it during maybe excuse me, like a particular war, or maybe there's a particular cause going on, and about the artist of one particular painting. So just a little bit of background information about the painting. That's what context just simply means. So your objective is students will construct a famous painting using objects that they will collect and find at home. Specifically, you're going to focus on shape and color for elements of art, and for principles of design, you're going to focus on unity. Okay? So, found objects are going to be from home, your media. Once again, we're going to have 10 school days, and we're looking at starting this today, Monday, April 13th, and this project will run from run until Friday, April 24th. Your points breakdown is it's going to have to be a famous painting, and when submitting your artwork, include the original image next to your piece so we can kind of compare between what you did and what your famous painting looks like. Minimum of 20 objects. I want you to pay attention close to the colors in your famous painting and when you're choosing your found objects, and they should be as similar as close as possible. Try and think about if you have any blank spaces, like a blank background. Make sure that you have objects that are going to be compact to each other, nothing spaced out, so that it looks like you still have the background still activated with what's going on. At least 70% of the whole famous painting needs to be showing, and pay attention if your painting is either in a landscape position, a portrait position, or a square. Minimum is going to be an 8.5 by 11. So for this example, this would be in the shape of a square. So assignments for this week, I'm just going to cover them once again, is for the week of April 13th through the 17th, which is this week. You just need to turn in your project notes, include your name. It can either be online or blank paper. And also this week, you're going to do two different sketches of famous paintings. So you'll get to choose, narrow it down to two paintings, and then next week you can start to really think about your project. So the following week, April 20th through the 24th, you're going to have your project due on the 24th, so next Friday, and then you're also going to just write me a little paper about your painting. So no more than 3/4 of a page. You can either type or handwrite it, and then you have a few questions that I want you to answer. So why did you choose your particular painting? Who is the artist? Know a little bit about background information about the artist. What is the date or time period that your famous painting was made? Like for instance, is it in the 15th century during the Renaissance? Is it during 19th century during a particular time period? Maybe it's like surrealism or expressionism. Just kind of be specific if you can of what time period. Is your painting in a particular museum? Where is it located? What is the original size of your painting? When you're looking this up, it might be in centimeters. Just do me a favor and just convert it to inches. If you just go into Google, if you just simply type in centimeters, convert to inches, you'll get like a little message on how to do that. It's really easy. You just put in what the centimeters is, and it'll convert it into inches for you. So, you can measure in inches or feet. And then, what is your painting about? Are there certain people, or a scene particularly going on? Is it a portrait of someone famous? Is it a landscape, of maybe trees, flowers? Is it a history painting, a genre, a still life? Kind of describe what type of a painting it actually is, okay? So I'm just giving you a list of various artists that you can look up. You might recognize some of these paintings. You can use that. So it's up to you. If you just need some reference of some different painting ideas, feel free to look any of these artists up. Here's just another list of various artists that you can use as well. So I'm just going to run through some examples and just kind of explain a little bit further. One of the requirements is at least 70%. So if you notice, it's just around where it's just getting about her shoulders and up. It's not including like her hands. That would be fine. So if you want to do kind of a little bit of a close-up, that's fine as well. So if there's too much else going on in your scene, just kind of at least focus on one particular part of your actual picture that you can use. The name of this one is called The Mona Lisa, and it's by the artist Leonardo da Vinci. This one is called The Kiss, and it's by the artist Gustav Klimt. And it's Klimt. This one is The Starry Night, Vincent van Gogh. I tried to choose ones that you guys probably or should have seen at some time in your life. Sunflowers, this is also by Vincent van Gogh. And I just want you to, look through this PowerPoint and look to see what types of objects they use and how it can be somewhat similar to what it actually looks like. Marilyn Monroe, this is Andy Warhol. This is during the pop art movement. So if you like pop art, Andy Warhol might be a really good artist to check out. Also, Keith Haring would be another good artist to look at. Some other examples of just famous paintings you might have seen that you could also think about is The Great Wave of Kanawaga, or it's also known as just The Great Wave. It's by the artist Hokusai. Another one is called The Screen by Edward Munch. The Birth of Venus by Botticelli. If you want to do something more on the abstract side, you got these two guys right here. They're really good. Composition Red, Blue, and Yellow by the artist Mondrian. And then another one is called Improvisation 28 Second Version by the artist Vasily Kandinsky. Okay? All right, guys. Well, hopefully this will help you out a little bit, get you moving. Please, again, if you have any questions, just feel free to email me on my school email. Look forward to hearing from you guys soon. Take care.